look, I don't have a problem with these people. I mean, I'm friends with you.
Bro, you have been glued to that thing all day. I know that retirement prep course wasn't exactly amazing, but you don't really seem like yourself. And not like I'm counting, but that was the third time you've screened her call.
Look, if you want to talk about something, I'm...
My kid almost killed himself last night. Overdose.
I don't even know what to say, but I'm glad that you told me.
Well, you're the only one I can talk to about this. I mean, you know this stuff.
Listen.
He doesn't even do drugs.
Well, this doesn't sound like an issue with addiction.
No. The doctor said he'll be okay. It's just that. It's one of those. You know, LGBT, non-binary kind of people.
You know, for a moment there, it sounded like you were more concerned about this than your kid almost.
I know. Look, I don't have a problem with these people. I mean, I'm friends with you. What I meant was...
It's different when it's family.
Yeah.
That's fair. This was unexpected.
I mean, we were fine before. Then we argue. Now we argue some more, then we're good, then we argue some more. You know, I feel like I already lost my son.
Or you've been given another chance to get to know who your kid really is.
And my wife, you know, she thinks I gotta go get counseling or something.
You don't need to have a disorder to talk to a therapist.
You don't?
No.
Wait. Why would they go?
Life gets complicated, you know? And it's just too many changes too fast. I mean, just look at the conversation we're having right now. You're trying to figure out if it's the best time to retire and leave your identity that you had for 30 years as a cop, all while your kid then comes out and then ODs. That's a lot.
This is her again. You know what? I should just retire.
I can recommend retirement.
There is no shortage of difficult conversations that people try to avoid. However, there are things that you can do to make them a little bit easier. When possible, instead of using questions, say prompting statements. This makes the dialogue come across conversational and not prosecutorial. This also helps the listener get answers to questions that were never asked, which is important when navigating difficult conversations. It can also reveal other issues impacting their world while acknowledging the ones that don't. Mental health clinicians sometimes use this technique when talking to their clients. However, anybody can use this form of dialogue when talking to somebody that's struggling with a crisis. At a time when it seems that division is all around us, this is something that we can all do to better our social environment and strengthen the connection that we have with each other.